Hey everybody, this is AP Macro, Unit 6. We've got the Open Economy, International Trade and Finance. We're doing subunit 6.3, the Foreign Exchange Market. Let's first just talk about the foreign exchange market, just this term right here. Sometimes you'll hear the Forex market. If anybody's ever talking about the Forex market, what they're saying is the foreign exchange market. That's just a short way to say the foreign exchange market. Also, the name that I like when I refer to this market is just a currency exchange market. That's also the same thing as a foreign exchange market. So this term right here, again, is equivalent to just saying a currency exchange market. And guys, I like that term because what does that connote? What is that, the connotation of that term? It means, hey, this is a place where one currency is being exchanged for another currency. And that's the important thing to understand about currency exchange market. That's what's happening. And guys, that leads me to something else. The fact that currency exchange markets, again, or foreign exchange markets, guys, those are means to an end. That's right, they're means to an end. What I'm trying to say, guys, is we don't go to a currency exchange market just to go to a currency exchange market, okay? We only go to a currency exchange market if we want to go interact in some other economy, right? We want to go to somebody else's product market or resource market or financial market. And again, those other people are only going to come to this market if they want to come to our product market, resource market, financial market. Here's the big thing. If you want to interact in the U.S. product market, resource market, or financial market, what type of currency are you going to need? You're going to need dollars, right? And so, when we talk about, say, the U.S. dollar market, which is going to be the example in this video, the U.S. dollar market, also called the USD market, what we're thinking about is these people, maybe people in Europe, okay, coming here demanding dollars, okay, so that they can go to one of those markets. And we're also thinking about Americans who might want to go to the European Union and participate in their product market, resource market, financial market. And guys, what type of currency are you going to need mainly to interact with that? And I say that because not every single country in the European Union uses the euro, but for most of those countries, what type of currency are you going to need? You're going to need the euro. So here's the idea. This market right here is showing Americans supplying their dollars in order to get the euros so they can go interact over here. So again, means to an end, right? I go here to go to one of those three markets, or somebody over here goes here to go to one of these three markets, right? So we're exchanging currencies because we want to go to some other market where we need a different currency, okay? Now, let's go into this a little bit more, okay? Let's talk just very quickly about what we've got right here. It says U.S. dollar market. Here's the big deal, guys. This is the amount of euros we're going to have to give up to get $1. What is this? This is the price of a dollar. This throws some students off. They hear dollar market, they want to put dollar in the numerator. Don't do that, guys. What we want in the numerator is what you have to give up and how much of that thing that you have to give up to get $1. That's the price of a dollar. Think about it this way, guys. If I had hot dog market, right? And let's say the hot dog market was in the United States. What would all the values on the vertical axis actually be? It would be the amount of dollars, think numerator, that you would have to give up to get one hot dog being in the denominator, right? Well, since this is a dollar market, this is showing the amount of euros you have to give up to get $1. And by the way, so this is a dollar market in terms of euros. Remember, we actually have dollar markets in terms of yen, dollar markets in terms of real. I mean, we have dollar markets in terms of every currency out there. I'm just picking the euro just to make it nice and simple. And I had to pick one, right, just to get the example out there. So anyhow, what again is this vertical axis? It's the price of dollars. What are we going to put on the horizontal? Quantity of dollars. Just like if it was a hot dog market, what would be here? Quantity of hot dogs, right? So I'm going to go ahead and fill that in. Quantity of dollars. Now, supply curve. Supply of what? Of course, the supply of dollars. So this is the supply of dollars. Just like, again, if it was the hot dog market, what would the supply curve represent? The supply of hot dogs. And then finally, you probably got it, right? What's this going to be the demand curve for? Demand for dollars, right? This is the demand for dollars. Just like if this was the hot dog market, that would be the demand for hot dogs, okay? So guys, everything we've learned about markets still applies for this type of market, okay? This is a market like all other markets, except for in this one, what's being bought and sold is not a good, not a service. Guys, it is the dollar, all right? So, who are the suppliers of dollars? I will often, for simplicity's sake, okay, from a teaching standpoint, say, hey, you think of those as Americans. They're the supplier of dollars. So from a conceptual standpoint, I'll do that from time to time. But guys, the real answer is, Who is the supplier of dollars? Is anybody who has dollars who wants euros, okay? That's the supplier of dollars. Anybody who has dollars that wants euros, okay? But again, for simplicity and for conceptual reasons, I'll often at times say, hey, think of Americans, okay? And I'm just doing this, not really referring to these markets. My hand's doing this, just saying people inside of this border, and that's supposed to be a border, that green line right there. People inside of this border are suppliers of dollars. Now, who's the demanders of dollars? Again, truly, anybody who has euros who wants dollars right now. That's the demanders of dollars. But for simplicity's sake, I'll oftentimes say, hey, it'd be Europeans, okay? They are the demanders of dollars. So, here's the deal. These people right here, Americans, being simplistic, they supply dollars. Why do they supply dollars? To go here, here, and here. And we've got Europeans. They demand dollars. Why do they demand dollars? To go here, here, and here. And guys, there is another truism that I want you to hear right now. Guys, this dollar market in terms of euros is really basically just the euro market in terms of dollars. We just have to flip things, okay? We'd have to flip a lot of things. But here's what I mean by that. The supplier of dollars is the demander of euros, right? And the demander of dollars is the supplier of euros. Hopefully that makes sense to you. And put it this way, guys, if I was to shift the supply of dollars to the right, what would I do to the demand for euros? I would also shift it right? An increase in the supply of dollars is an increase in the demand for dollars. And guys, if I was to shift the demand for dollars to the right, what would I do to the supply of euros? I would shift it right? If I'm saying there's more demand for the dollars, there must be more supply of the euros. The only way people can be demanding the dollar, more of the dollar, is to supply more of the euros. Okay, hopefully that makes sense. Finally, let's talk about the equilibrium. Well, guys, this equilibrium right here is associated with some exchange rate, some euros that would have to be given up to get $1, some amount of euros have to be given up to get $1, okay? So it would be associated with some exchange rate that would give us a situation where the quantity supplied of dollars equals the quantity demanded for dollars. And guys, when it comes to the U.S. dollar market in terms of euros, this market is very efficient at finding this market clearing exchange rate. Market clearing means a situation where we get the quantity supplied of dollars and the quantity demanded of dollars to be equal, okay? Now, finally, as we finish this up, this particular video up, let's talk about this. Supply of dollars, it's upward sloping, right? Why is it upward sloping? Why is that exchange rate goes up, does the quantity supply of dollars increase, okay? Why, as that exchange rate increases, does that supply of dollars increase? Here's the reason, guys. As we go this direction, as that dollar appreciates, as you have to give up more euros to get a dollar, okay, the purchasing power, the international purchasing power of the dollar is increasing. So what that means is Americans will be like, hey, I'm going to now supply more dollars because my dollar goes even further in these other in this other country's economy or these other countries' economies, okay? And so since my dollar goes further now, it has more purchasing power, I'm going to supply more of it. So as we go that direction, you can see the quantity supply getting bigger and bigger and bigger as Americans are willing to supply even more as their purchasing power is going up. But here's the interesting thing, right? As that dollar appreciates, guys, what that means is what's happening to the quantity demanded, okay? So I'm gonna have to use another color. I'm gonna make this a really, really ugly graph. But guys, hey, at this low price of the dollar, right? Look at the quantity demanded, it's quite a bit. As the dollar begins to appreciate, that horizontal distance, look at the green line, right? Now let's say it appreciates even more, that horizontal depreciates more. That horizontal distance is getting smaller, smaller, and smaller. Why? Because guys, as the dollar appreciates, all of this stuff is becoming more expensive. And so people over here are gonna wanna come to these markets all the less. And really, not so much the financial market, we'll get into why not so much the financial market, but the resource market and the product market, definitely people over here are not gonna wanna come to these markets near as much as that dollar's appreciating. As that dollar becomes more expensive, everything in these markets become more expensive. And so guess what? They're quantity demanded of the dollar is decreasing, okay? So again, what we've got is a positive relationship when it comes to the supply of dollars, right? As the dollar appreciates, goes up in value, the quantity supplied of dollars is going to increase because that purchasing power of dollars is becoming greater. And so people are going to supply more and more as they can buy more and more stuff. With their dollar buys more and more stuff. It's probably the best way to say it, right? However, the demand for dollars is an inverse relationship to the price of the dollar. As the price of the dollar goes up, all of this stuff becomes more expensive. People over here are going to want to come here less, right? They're going to want to come here less. So as we go up, the quantity demanded is going to decrease, okay? I know that's ugly. Hopefully that made sense to you. That's our first run at a foreign exchange market, known as the Forex market, known as the currency exchange market. Again, this is a market that is a means to an end. Hope that makes sense to you. We'll see you in the next video.